Welcome back to EVS class. Last class we went to Hyderabad, right? Did you enjoy? Okay, so today also we are going to a place, but that place is not in our earth. Then where? Do you have doubt there? Right? So we are going to space. Are you ready to go? Okay. Then how do we go? Which vehicle we used to go? Tell me. Plane? No. We used to go by spaceship. Have you seen spaceship? No. Look at this. It is a vehicle used to travel in space. Before going to space, you should know about a space. How do we know? Here comes Sunitha Williams. She spent 6 months in a space. So, let us hear her experience in a space. Now we can hear about Sunitha Williams. Who was Sunitha Williams? Sunitha Williams is an American astronaut and United Nations Navy officer. She born on 19th September 1965 in America. She is the second American astronaut of Indian heritage to go to space. She has the record of 195 days in space. She went to International Space Station 9th December 2006 in space flight. She holds the record of most spacewalk time for woman 15 hours and 40 minutes in 7 spacewalks. Children, do you know who is an astronaut? Astronaut is a person who goes in space to learn about space, planets and heavenly bodies. Now, we can learn about some famous astronaut. First is Neil Armstrong. He is the first man step into the surface of the moon. He was an American. Then, Wing Commander Rakesh Sharma. He was the first Indian to go to space. Next is Kalpana Chawla. She was the first woman of Indian origin to go to space. In 1997, she went to space in an American space shuttle Columbia and died in an unfortunate accident with her crew members. Last one is Sunitha Williams. After Kalpana Chawla, she was the second woman went to space. Now we can hear about Sunitha's experience of living in space. We could not sit at one place. We kept floating in the spaceship from one end to another. Water too does not stay at one place. It floats around as blob. To wash our face or hands, we had to catch these blobs and wet paper with them. We ate very differently there. The real fun was when all of us would float into the dining area of the spaceship and catch the floating food packets. In space, there was no need to use a comb. My hair kept standing all the time. Not being able to walk, we had to get used to floating around. We had to learn to do simple things differently. To stay at one place, we had to strap ourselves there. Purpose also had to be stuck to the wall of the spaceship. It was a lot of fun living in space, but it was also difficult. Can you think why Sunitha's hair was standing? When we are on the earth, our hair remains in downward position because of the gravitation pull of earth. But in space, there is no gravity, so hair keeps standing. Think why water flows downward on any slope? On mountains too, water flows downwards, not upwards. Water flows downwards because of the force of gravity of the earth. Now look at this picture. Uzaira and Shahmir are playing with the glob. What is glob? Glob is a miniature model of earth. Then Shahmir asked Uzaira, where is space? Space is everything in the universe beyond the top of the Earth atmosphere. The sky, stars, sun and the moon, they all are in space. What is our Earth like? The Earth is spherical in shape, also called geoid shape. It looks like a blue from a space. That is why it is also called blue planet. The Earth is the third planet from the sun and the only planet to have a living life. Where are we? Look at this red mark on the picture. Here we are. This is India. You can also find out other countries on the globe. Are we inside the Earth? This question must have come to your mind also. If we were inside the Earth, we would not be able to see the sky, sun, the moon and the stars. So, we are on or outer surface of the Earth. If Earth is round like a globe, how is it that we do not fall off? We do not fall off because the gravitational force of the Earth attracts everything towards itself. It works like a magnet. Now, you also know why does not sea water fall off? Students, look at this picture. This is Argentina. That is an lower part of the Earth. There are other countries like Brazil, Australia, Africa, etc. also in lower part of the Earth. Do the people in Argentina stand upside down? No, they also stand up like us. The sense of up and down on the Earth is relative. That means direction away from the Earth is up and direction towards Earth is down. What are the things you see in a night sky? In the night sky, you can see moon, star, shooting stars and even satellites. What is shooting star? A shooting star is a piece of rock or metal that burns very brightly when it enters the Earth atmosphere from space. What are satellites? Satellites are celestial bodies that revolves around the planets. There are two satellites. One natural satellites, another one artificial satellite. Why we can't see them in daytime? They don't hide, but the sun is too bright during the day, much more brighter than this object, so we are not able to see them. Have you seen moon changing its time? Yes, look at this. Suppose you see a full moon today, then after a week, you will notice that size of the moon is reduced to half. And after 15 days, it will disappear completely. This is called a new moon and there is no moon in the night sky. After a week, it will grow back to half again. And a week after that, it will be a full moon again. So, from full moon to full moon, it is a month long cycle. Now, look at the globe. There are lines between the different countries on the globe. Are such lines also there on the Earth? No. Where are the lines? These lines are only man-made. If you travel from one state to another state or one country to another country, you will not find any such lines. These are just imaginary lines marking the boundaries of states or countries. That's all in this lesson. See you next class. Bye-bye.